Yo guys, Jarek here doing some Azure Sheep. It's a Half-Life 1 mod. And this was made by the same people that made that other Half-Life 1 mod that I had a playthrough of called Point of View. My impression on this one is that the first half of the game is two things. One, kind of bland, nothing about it really sticks out. And two, frustrating, just fucking horrible at times. A lot of the times they'll throw you too many enemies and they just don't have very good enemy balancing. The game becomes way too hard. Or, they had one part of the game where you had no guns and had to run through a bunch of enemies, and after dying a million fucking times, I just went, fuck this, and turned on God mode and ran through that area. And on top of that, you had to make sure your partner, who you have to do a stupid escort mission with, you gotta make sure she doesn't die as well, but... getting past that, I've gotten to the second portion of the game, and this so far has been a lot better than the first half. Better programming, more fun, not as many enemies to screw you over, better enemy placement. I'm just having a lot more fun at the second half of the game. And right now, I'm currently in Zen. I was on Earth for most of the game, and now I'm on Zen. But the reason I am uploading gameplay of this is, actually, you'll see it. Giant battle going on over here. And you can tell by the way those guns sound. They are not the normal assault rifle. Oh, also, this game, I installed a HD pack for it, so all the guns look really, real nice. And I have two pistols, but I can't tell the difference between them. I have this one, and then I have this one, different mag capacities. One sounds different, but I'm pretty sure they use the same ammo, and they have the same damage, so I don't know why I have two different pistols that look the same. Oh, fucking elevator got in the way. I hate these enemies. Yeah, get out of here. Well, I don't have much ammo for that, so I'll just use a crossbow. Wow, I have a lot of crossbow bolts. Why am I not using this? Oh, more, you guys? Come on. Stop moving. There we go. I think they made it so it's one crossbow bolt kills these guys. Thank God. That's the other thing about this mod that kind of annoys me. You can't see your freaking crosshair. Like, it's just too dark. So. Oh, damn, he moved. They're all just kind of having a circle jerk with their third arm in the corner. See, that was some Battlefield skills there. Oh, shit. Oh, that totally would have hit him! There's a giant invisible wall around that stupid elevator. Also, yeah, this is why I'm recording this. Fuck yeah, pulse rifle. Uses the same ammo as the assault rifle, same grenades and everything, I'm pretty sure. But it sounds different, and that's just fucking badass. I'm pretty sure it has the same damage as well. I don't know if the accuracy is the same. Holy shit, no, that's stronger by a lot. So hopefully this will fill the void left in Half-Life 1. Oh shit. Oh god, the rate of fire is definitely higher as well. And it uses the actual alien's pulse rifle sound, so that's pretty badass. Hopefully this will fill the void that Half-Life 1 had, because it had an SMG and a revolver and a, you know, a crossbow, stuff like that. But it didn't really have an assault rifle that was good for, you know, medium range engagements or all around type stuff like that. So hopefully this will fill that void. Whoop. These guys seem to be kind of stupid around this corner. Get away. Can I hit them from that far? No, I can't. Also, yeah, taking a short break of the darkness too, playing something else. This is definitely a much better. I think it's pretty much the same thing with the different skin, different sound effects, and more accurate. I wonder if the grenades just fly straight now. And if you have to pump the, I'm gonna find out. Quick save. That sounds awesome. Bodies. Okay, loading, because I don't want to waste ammo. There is a Vortigaunt around here. Whoop! Oh god, I continued to fall after I hit that teleporter. That panic made me panic. Hey, I'm on Earth again. Something really cool about this, though, that I have noticed is that they have a lot of crossovers between games. There was a few crossovers to the last mod, Point of View, or maybe it wasn't Point of View. Maybe Point of View had a few crossovers to this game. I think this one came out first. There's a few crossovers to Opposing Force. I don't know if there's a few to Blue Shift. I don't think I've seen some yet. A lot of crossovers to Half-Life 1. For the first part of the game, you're running all along that original monorail that you start out in Half-Life 1. There's like a separate path next to that that you're taking for the longest time to get to that the test site. So, a lot of crossovers. Really, really cool. Another one down. I hear a frog. Where is it? Oh, there it is. Yeah, I got another frog. These things are the best. I'm going to use these. Uh-oh. Did she just... You idiot. Whoa! Where the fuck did you come from? Holy shit, that scared me. Okay, how much health do you have? Oh, I guess she has full health.